October 2013, Schuylerville's sixth graders and their teachers embarked on a new educational journey, a pilot program using iPads to support teaching and learning. The goal? To improve student achievements by tailoring instruction to individual student needs and increasing student engagement.
We're using iPads for like notability and stuff, and we use them to go on the internet and do web quests, which are quests that you do online that help you with the topic that you're working on.
Each of the district's 140 sixth graders was assigned an iPad to use in class and at home. 30 devices were also made available for high school chemistry students to use on a rotating basis during the school day. Putting these high-tech tools in the hands of students and teachers has added new dimensions to today's classrooms.
The kids are super excited about using the iPads. They tend to volunteer more because a lot of times they can answer a question on the iPad without raising their hand. A lot of kids that typically would be shy in a classroom are engaged a little bit more. I find that a lot of the activities we do are student-driven instead of teacher-paced, so that way if the students have a question, we can take a step back, they can find the answer on their iPads, and then we can continue on versus, I don't know the answer to that one, I'll have to get back to you, and then it becomes not as natural.
eSpark software is used to help personalize each sixth grader's educational experience. By analyzing a student's strengths and weaknesses, eSpark creates individual learning plans for each pupil and then assigns quests, or learning activities, for each student to complete. The quests consists of software apps, videos, and assessments that are both fun and educational.
On eSpark, I have to do the video at the end of the quest, and I have to figure out a problem or summarize what I've learned.
How I'm using the iPads in class is always on a daily basis. It stems from maybe a warm-up when the kids come in, usually asking some questions and maybe some of the topics we covered the previous day. I use it to guide my lessons through either a whole group presentation or maybe a small group practice on what we're covering, particularly in class. And with the iPads themselves, it allows me to kind of gauge how the kids are doing. I'm able to see what they're doing, what kind of work they're doing instantly on my iPad. And from there, I'm able to decide whether I have to review something I've covered. If I'm in the middle of a lesson and I'm seeing that students are struggling or making similar mistakes, it's something that I can adjust on the fly and maybe recover what I just taught and try to hit those particular kids. When I didn't have iPads, I wouldn't really know if the kids were understanding everything clearly until maybe the next day or maybe when a test was given. You know, I was always a little bit behind. Now I'm right on top of them and I can see what they're doing throughout the whole class. It's pretty great.
With multiple users for each iPad at the high school, Schuylerville's chemistry students share a suite of chemistry-related apps researched and chosen by the classroom teacher.
I probably looked at over 500 apps this summer. And one of my criteria was, you know, maybe the budget, I didn't know what my budget was. So I tried to, if it wasn't a free app, I didn't look at it immediately. If it was a paid app, I explored whether or not it was a tool of value that I could use and possibly use as a demonstration. And if it would accentuate anything that we did in class, then I would purchase it from my personal iPad. But I tried to keep it free apps that were productive and relevant to the class.
Students are taking control of their education.
There's a spot in the app where you can pull down worksheets, and then it's basically worksheets that your teacher has printed out on paper or that she has made. So we have the choice to do it on paper or the iPad. It's a lot of fun.
In just a few short months, Schuylerville's educators have found that the craft of teaching is changing. Teachers are moving from the traditional role of sage on the stage to more of a partner in education or guide on the side.
There are many advantages to the students using the iPads in the classroom. They're definitely finding that they can do more on the iPad individually at their own pace, which is a big deal. The classes are very diverse on what certain students can handle and what pace they can handle. It used to be that the teacher would kind of go at the pace of kind of the slowest or medium to slowest person in the classroom, and some of the more advanced kids probably wanted it to speed up a little bit. One of the advantages of this is I can kind of set them free and they can kind of work at their own pace, and I can enrich the ones that need enrichment. I can pull the smaller group and work with them when they are struggling on something.
Schuylerville's iPad pilot program is already showing positive impacts.
The engagement level is huge in the class. In math, just like many subjects, it's not some student's strong suit. And so those kids maybe will shy away from a typical raising a hand in class or coming up to the board or sharing what they have for an answer. And with the ability for the kids to do work on their iPad and for me to be able to see the work they're doing, they can share it with me. It's basically as if they were raising their hand in class, but they're sharing with me between me and them. And it gives me an idea of how they're doing, whether they understand the concept. And they don't have to feel self-conscious about whether this is really a strong suit for them. Because for math, it's just like every subject, it's not everybody's strong suit. So they're not, some people aren't the best at math. But they're very engaged and they're interactive in every lesson. It's been a great tool.
Teachers and the technology staff can easily monitor students' iPad usage and make adjustments quickly if any issues arise.
No, I feel like the homework is easier because it explains it better. The teachers, like, they'll have us pull down a sheet from Notability to put into our notes that we do for homework. That, like, it gives you every single inch of directions that you need. And if you don't get it, then you can email your teachers to make it easier for you.
Sixth graders were chosen to be the main focus of Schuylerville's iPad pilot program for several reasons. First, other districts found that this grade level reaped the most academic benefits when integrating iPads. Sixth graders also have the maturity level to handle the devices and to begin taking control of their own learning experiences. Of course, having a teaching staff enthusiastic about embracing new technologies also came into play.
When I use my iPad in my instruction, one, I have to know what I'm using it for, so I have to be prepared. One of the apps that we use that even has inspired students to download onto their mobile devices, like their smartphones and whatnot, is this interactive periodic table. It's beautiful. And it actually does everything that we do, or needed to do, and even then more. But because it's visually stunning and it's very modern, you know, it's more than just dots and lines on a graph. I can project, 3D graphs of whatever we're doing. Like if we're studying atomic radius, this periodic table will project up the regular periodic table, but imprinted over these icons that represent the elements, it now puts a 3D atom so we can actually visualize what the size of the atoms look like.
Schuylerville is moving above and beyond traditional teaching and learning practices with the iPad initiative. Looking to the future, if sufficient academic gains are made, the iPad program will likely expand to other grade levels.
So, and eventually that's what I would like, it's inspire these kids to go above and beyond.